This is Frank. This is a 2003 Toyota HIghlander with a 3.0 liter V6 1MZ-FE engine. This engine has a very serious leak out of the rear main seal. So the engine is also kind of sludged up, which is typical for these engines. So we're going to drop this drivetrain and replace the engine with a fresh new JDM engine. This is the JDM engine that is going to go into the car. I am going to document on video every single step that I take in removing and replacing the engine. I've already started with the strut bar, the airbox, the intake tube, and the battery that you can see right here. I'm going to start doing everything that I can with the car on the ground, and then I'll move to the things that I do from under the car after I lift the car. This is my task list that I am going to keep as I work along. Next step is the throttle cables. Next, this engine strut mount. Drain the radiator. Remove the radiator hoses, top hose, bottom hose. Here's the top hose. The bottom hose I'm just going to tuck out of the way for now. How are we doing with our list? We already got 5 steps. Let's keep going. Recover the AC. You didn't think I was just going to blow it out, did you? Disconnect both AC hoses from the compressor and fold them back out of the way. Disconnect the heater hoses from the engine. We're going to tuck these back out of the way. And since we are right here, we're going to remove the starter. This starter has the stud on the underside. You have to pull the starter before you can remove the nut holding the power supply to the starter. Also note there's a ground wire coming from the strut tower to one of the starter bolts, and don't forget to put this back in. As long as we're doing electrical, let's open up the fuse box and disconnect this power supply wire. This just comes off of this little stud right here. Then we have these two power connectors. And this ground wire on the battery tray is attached to the harness. How's our list doing? We're up to 10 things. The fun is only just starting. Down under the battery, we have the transmission shift cable. Let's get it out. This has this little jam thing that you have to know how to remove. Listen, if you don't know how to remove one of these things, then you have no business swapping an engine. So here we have the shift cable. I'm going to disconnect the Evap hose from right here. Next, the fuel hose. This has tabs that you squeeze. So the fuel hose is off the fuel line. You can see one of the tabs on the top. There's another one like it on the bottom. Let's not forget this ground wire right here. One end was going to the transmission and the other end goes to the head right here. The engine harness goes through the firewall right there. We're going to go into the cabin and release the harness from the ECU. The ECU is right behind the glove box. And those three bottom connectors on the ECU are the three that go to the engine harness. The two top ones are for the body harness. With a little bit of struggle, here's the harness. This is the flange that goes against the firewall. This reverse connector that's on the harness is just a, you know, it's kind of a little B to get this out because it points the wrong way and it wants to jam in that hole right there. So you have to get it from inside the cabin. You have to reach way back and line this up with the hole. And here's the rest of the harness. We have two ground wires here. They have just pop connectors. We pop them out. So they're both out, tuck them away. Power steering reservoir is right here. This connects to the pump, and this goes to a hard line. The way to do this is disconnect this hose right here and remove the whole reservoir and put it on top of the engine. I had a little plastic bottle at the ready for when I disconnected the hose. And here the reservoir is disconnected from its mounting point right there. It still remains connected to the power steering pump, but it is disconnected from the frame so it can come out with the engine. We have done almost everything that can be done from the top. Let's check our list again. We're up to 16 items. Way to go. The wheels are off. Let's get the axles out. To remove the tie rods, I use a tie rod removal tool. The axles are out, both sides. Next, I'm gonna remove the hubs. This is not really necessary, but they're just in the way of everything hanging there, so I'm gonna remove them. I'm gonna drain the engine oil and drain the transmission. Don't forget to disconnect this power steering cooler hose right here. It goes into a tube on the subframe. Let's remove the white pipe. The white pipe has bolts here and here and up there. Here's the exhaust. Next, we want to get this passenger side axle completely out. This axle has a carrier that's bolted to the block and a bearing that can be very difficult to get out of the carrier. Let's see how we do. There, I have knocked it right out using this drift and this sledge. The steering linkage can be reached from the side, or you can reach the steering linkage from the back. You do this by removing the clamping bolt, and then you use a fork to gently pry it upwards without damaging the boot. And once you get it past the spline, then it's just gonna lift out the rest of the way. Let's see how our list is doing. I started a new column for the things that you do underneath. You just want to note the number 5 and 6 you can do in the opposite order. If you remove the exhaust first, then it makes it easier to tap out the axle carrier bearing. There are just a few things left. There's the transmission cooler line here and here. We have this little harness that goes into the motor mount. We're getting down to the home stretch, so we're gonna separate the flywheel from the torque converter, and we're gonna unfasten any of these transmission bolts that are easier to reach from underneath. To unfasten the flywheel bolts, I put a 22 millimeter socket on the crankshaft, and I put a 14 millimeter socket on each flywheel bolt, and I turned them in opposite directions. There are 6 flywheel bolts. One of them has a little bit different color head than the others, and it has a little shoulder on it. And this is the bolt that goes back in first. The first one you put back in, and it is an alignment bolt. Gonna unfasten these plastic undercovers. They're actually part of the wheel well liner on either side. I'm gonna fold them back out of the way. Let's take another look at the list. And I think this completes it, and we're ready to drop the subframe. Let's look at what's left here. We got on each side two large bolts that hold the subframe up into the frame of the car. And each one of these bolts has a supporting flange or bracket, has two additional bolts in the rear, and same thing behind the bumper in the front. So to proceed, I'm gonna lower the car down onto some jack stands. I'm gonna put these under the subframe, make sure the subframe is very well supported, and then I'm gonna start undoing all of these bolts. I've released all the supporting bolts of the subframe. So now if my calculations are correct, when I lift the car, the subframe in the engine should stay on the jack stands. So there was something sticking on one side. Let's try to figure out what it is. There was just one thing that did not enter into my calculations. That thing was corrosion. So corrosion was holding this corner and not allowing it to release. So I used this fork, slipped it through, kind of aiming where I thought it would be, because there's this pad was up like this, okay, and just aimed straight through, and the fork was able to knock this loose. So now the subframe can detach and the body of the car can lift off. So if you run into this situation, this is how you get out of it. Let's try this again one more time. So there it is. For the next step, I'm going to disconnect the entire harness and it's going to be going to the new engine. I've disconnected the harness entirely and pulled it back from the engine. Next, I remove the exhaust manifolds front and back. Here we have both exhaust manifolds off the car. There's still some coolant left in the block. I'm draining out what's left through this block drain. Remove the power steering pump in the power steering bracket. Next step is to separate the engine from the transmission. Support the engine with the engine crane. The engine has lift points on each head. Remove the remaining bell housing bolts. There should be four remaining. Remove the engine mounts. There is one on the passenger side and one on the rear. This engine mount needs to come out completely. The engine is separated from the transmission, is supported by the crane, and you can just pull it out. I put a random bracket with a bolt on here so the torque converter does not fall out. I've set it down on a little dolly. And there it is. It's all out. If you place a 2x4 underneath the bell housing flange, then the engine will be well supported and well balanced. Now installation is the reverser removal, right? Thank you for watching this video. Hope you found it interesting.